Okay, now let us analyze the second case. Second case, plane is perpendicular to HP and inclined to BP. Okay, tell me, since here also the lamina is inclined to one plane and perpendicular to other, I need to do it in two stages. Okay, now we have stage 1 and stage 2. What about stage 1? In stage 1, I need to assume something. So what is that stage that I need to show? Here, since the lamina is inclined to BP, I will assume that lamina to be parallel to VP. Now since the lamina is parallel to VP, true shape and size will be seen in front view. So I need to start from front view. That is my first conclusion. Next conclusion is regarding the orientation. So what about the orientation? As I told you, that has to be derived from the problem statement. So it is given that this particular lamina of side 30mm is resting on one of its corners in VP or on VP. Now since it is resting on one of its corners on VP, what I said, in the initial position, that corner and the center of the lamina, if I join that particular line, that line should be parallel to XY line or parallel to HP. It is just similar to what I told you for the top view. Only thing is for the top view I used to say HP details. Here I am telling VP details, now I am telling HP details. Okay, I am just going to demonstrate this, then I am going to solve this. Okay, now anyway, as you can see, this I just taken a pentagonal lamina. You can just see this is a pentagonal lamina. Okay, of 30mm side, resting one of its corners, anyway, that we will see later. Is perpendicular to HP and inclined to VP. Since it is inclined to VP, I told you that this particular lamina should be parallel to VP. Since it is parallel to VP, I need to keep in this way. And since I wanted one of the corners to be VP itself, I will say this lamina itself is resting on VP. I am going to do like this. So anyway, I know that I need to start from top view, I mean front view. Now tell me what about the orientation. Can I simply randomly like this and can I simply inclined with reference to VP? I cannot do it. If I do this, what will happen? If I simply make this inclination with reference to VP, then what will happen is it will rest on some corner. But what I wanted, I want all of you to do a unique solution. Unique solution is possible when everybody does in the same fashion. So what is that same fashion in this case? Here what I assume is the corner. This is the corner, no? This particular corner and the center of the lamina, maybe I will just not do BDS, I will just go to the center. Okay, the center of the lamina and this particular corner, if I join, this particular line should be parallel to HP. So maybe I am just doing this way. Now what I do, this is my initial position. That is, in the initial position, I will draw the figure like this. This is my front view. Now, front view is over. What about the top view? If I look from the top, as usual you can see, since I wanted this corner to be in VP, I am considering the entire lamina in VP itself. Since the lamina itself is in VP, in the top view, this lamina will be on XY line. So that is my initial position. So what about the next position? In the next position, I am going to show the inclination. So where to show the inclination? Since because the lamina is seen as a line in which view? In the top view. So I need to redraw the top view. How do you redraw the top view? As you can see, I need to just lift it like this. So you lift it like this, then or if I orient like this, this corner will rest on the ground and also I can show the inclination. That is, I am going to simply rotate the line. So once I rotate the line, you can see in the top view, that particular lamina will be a line which is inclined at 45 degrees to VP. Whereas in the front view, because anyway, once I lift it, what will happen? This corner will come closer to this particular corner itself, so that it becomes smaller in size. Remember, as I told you in the case of lines also, I told you that locus, no? Here also, instead of there, we had only two locus lines. Only two ends, because we have so many ends. So every end is a locus line. All those locus lines has to be parallel to XY line. Is it okay? So let us do this. So as I was telling you, I need to here start from what? Start from front view. Okay, draw the XY line. Draw the XY line. Now I need to draw the pentagon. How to draw the pentagon now? I need to draw the pentagon such that the corner containing the two isometric equal inclinations. Now just to have demonstrated that if I having this corner in this particular way, this corner and the center of this lamina is parallel. So if this is the case, What about its side opposite to corner? How it will be? We can see the side opposite to corner will be a line, vertical line. See, always if I want to draw the lamina, I need to see how easily I can draw the lamina. Because anyway, I told you that I cannot start from here. Because if I start from here, I need to, anyway, you know, see your included angle. So, what is the included angle I said? It is 108, then I need to draw a line, then I should 108, then it is very difficult. So, instead of that, what you do is you first start from this, okay, then draw the lamina like this, or you can also draw like this. Also, you draw. See, while lifting, either I can lift like this or like that. Remember, especially for a pentagon, you should be careful. If I orient like this, it rests on a side on VP. But if I orient to this side, then a corner is in VP. So, but that is a unique case for a pentagon. Whereas in the previous case, I told you a square is a symmetrical figure, both about x axis and y axis. So, I can rotate in either way. Even hexagon also same thing. But especially for the pentagon, you should be careful. Okay, now let us say I will start like this only. Then I am orienting the other way. Because anyway, in the previous problem, I have just oriented like this. Here I am orienting the other way. So you can do it any fashion. Okay. So let us draw the pentagon. Let me say I will draw in this way only. Okay, first I will draw one side. So now I have taken one of the side to be perpendicular to XY line, perpendicular to HP. Now I need to complete the pentagon. I think already I told you in the previous class how to complete the pentagon. So I will simply draw that. So when this is the line, center. So how do you find the center? Always remember, I need to draw a bisector. Bisector. So wherever it joins, I am going to get the center. Okay. So we have the center. The center point is not required for this case. I have just written the pentagon. Okay. How do you name them? Again, I showed that you have to follow a particular trend. So what is the trend I said? For this particular front view, this is a plane. This is an object. Observer. So observer always start from the leftmost visible point. So this is visible. Next visible is this. So obviously here I can say start from leftmost visible point in the clockwise direction. Okay. So let us say this is A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, and E dash. Okay. Then draw the corresponding top view. So top view, as I was telling you, we want this particular corner to rest on VP. Since I want this corner to rest on VP, I will assume the entire lamina is in VP itself. That is the reason I am just drawing this top view on XY line itself. So this is my top view. Okay, now again points. So A, B, C, D, E. See, without seeing this I can draw. How it is possible for me to draw like this? Because anyway, I just named the points in a particular fashion. So if you want to follow a particular fashion, so that you will not do any mistakes in the other figure. See, there is no order first. You should always start. You can also start from here also. You can start, but there is no order first. But if you do it in a particular fashion, chances of you doing mistake is very, very less. Is it okay? Okay, now this is my first view. So what is this anyway? This is the stage one. What about stage two? Stage two is given that lamina is inclined at 45 degrees to VP. Now since in the top view it is seen as a line, I need to redraw the top view. I need to redraw the top view such that lamina is inclined at 45 degrees to VP. Okay, now tell me how do you redraw this figure? Either like this or like that. Tell me, anyway, for this particular case, I wanted a corner to be on VP. Now since I wanted a corner to be on VP, this C should be on XY line. Let us say if I say it is resting on one of the sides in VP, then I would have taken AE on XY. So remember, especially in the case of pentagon, you should be careful in which direction you are orienting. So in this particular problem, since I wanted one of the corners to rest on VP or in VP itself, I need to redraw the figure such that C should be on XY line itself. Okay, so let us redraw that figure. So I will just again take this distance and I am just going to put it like this. Just remember, I am simply redrawing the figure. That would say that dimensions, everything should be same. and all these points, wherever it was there only. I cannot change it. Okay. So this is C. Then I will take this distance. I will mark it. Then I will take this distance. I will mark it. Okay. So I will say this is A, B, C, D, E. E. And this angle is 45 degrees. Is it? Okay, now I need to get the new front view. So what are the new front view? Now we know that in the new front view, since the lamina is inclined VP, the front view should be smaller in size. So how do you get that new front view? To get the new front view, always draw the projectors from the, or I can say vertical projectors from the new top view, and draw the horizontal projectors from the previous front view. So always remember those statements. So remember, I am just drawing all the projectors now. So projector should be as neat as possible. Remember always. Okay, now let us transfer the points now. A. Where is A? A projector, A projector. I will get this A dash. Then B projector, B projector. B dash. Similarly, C projector, C projector. C. Then D projector, D projector, D dash. Then finally, E projector and E projector. So I just got the points. Remember, all these points we got by the intersection of these vertical and horizontal projectors. Now I need to join them. Again, how do you join? Always start from the first one. Let us start from A. So again, join them in the same proper sequence. So what are the sequence? A to B, then B to C, then C to D, D to E, and E back to A. Now we can see in the final front view, it will be smaller in size. And always remember one more thing, I just forgot. Once you draw this particular figure, since one of the side is vertical, anyway this corner making equal inclinations with these two sides, or I can say the corner and this particular center is parallel to XY. Remember, the projectors through BD should be the same projector. That you should ensure. Let us say if B and D are different projector, means you have not drawn the figure properly. Is it okay? So now, as you can see, I have started from here. So always see the sequence. I started with this figure first. First figure, second figure. Which is the next figure? Third figure. Fourth. So remember, always you have the same sequence. Maybe in the next class, if I go to the oblique. Oblique means what? Oblique planes means the lamina inclined to both the planes. Now as you can see here, the lamina here parallel to VP and perpendicular to HP. Then I said that lamina is inclined to VP and it is still perpendicular. I mean, the lamina is inclined to VP and still perpendicular to HP. But what are the oblique planes? In the case of oblique planes, the lamina inclined to both the planes. That we say that if I draw the stage 3, I am going to get the case where lamina is inclined to both HP as well as VP, which I am going to do in the next session. Okay, thank you.